Greetings from Mission Control Houston, and welcome to Space Station Live. The crew of Expedition 36 currently locked into a number of maintenance tasks and get-ahead work for major upcoming operations over the next few weeks. Starting off with Commander Vinogradov, who's over in the Russian segment this morning installing an onboard measurement system for payload monitoring throughout some of the Russian payload experiments. He's also transferring some cargo from one of the unmanned cargo vehicles currently docked to the International Space Station, the 52P. Meanwhile, his fellow Russian cosmonaut Alexander Mazurkin was busy earlier installing some samples for an experiment on board the station, which is looking to study the effects of space environment factors on the strain and also strength and fatigue characteristics of different materials exposed to the outside vacuum of space. He'll also be doing some repair work on a Chibis M satellite, a small free-flying Russian satellite, which is designed to study lightning and plasma in the upper Earth's atmosphere. Also, he'll be reviewing quite a few EVA or spacewalk procedures and translation paths out through the windows pointing to the outside of the Russian segment as Mazurkin and Yurchikhin are reviewing all these checklists and timelines as they prepare for two upcoming spacewalks on August 16th and August 22nd. They'll be stepping outside, but today they'll be reviewing the checklists and all the timelines and tasks that they'll be responsible for during those spacewalks, and also mapping out their paths that they'll be translating along the outside of the International Space Station. Meanwhile, Chris Cassidy is doing quite a bit of work today to prepare for the arrival of another unmanned cargo craft, the HTV. He'll be setting up and testing the HTV-4 control panel. Alongside him will be Karen Nyberg. They'll be using this to monitor the approach of the craft when it arrives tomorrow on Friday. If necessary, they can use the control panel to send commands to the spacecraft to abort its approach in the event of any system malfunctions. Cassidy and Nyberg also doing some on-orbit training today with the space station's robotic arm, which you can see here will be used to grapple and later dock the HTV to the Earth-facing port of the Harmony module. He and Nyberg doing a quick refresher course on that. The HTV, which launched back on Saturday, August 3rd at 2:48 p.m. Central Time from the Tanegashima Space Center in southern Japan, as of about 7 a.m. this morning on Thursday, was just a little over 1,000 miles behind the International Space Station, just about 18 miles beneath its current orbit. It'll be completing a number of burns from its main engines and control thrusters today to continue to raise its orbit and catch up with the International Space Station as it closes in for that grapple time tomorrow at 6:29 a.m. Central Time, with berthing expected to begin about 2 hours later, again to the Earth-facing side of Harmony. Russian cosmonaut Fyodor Yurchikhin will be assisting Mazurkin in those Chibis satellite repairs, also spending the big bulk of his day in that EVA review as he and Mazurkin prepare for those upcoming spacewalks in their Russian Orlan spacesuits on August 16th and 22nd. European astronaut Luca Parmitano earlier today completed a monthly periodic fitness evaluation. He was using the CVIS device, or the cycle ergometer with vibration isolation and stabilization, one of the numerous exercise devices on board. He'll also be spending some time inside of the European ATV-4 craft. This is another unmanned cargo vehicle currently docked to the International Space Station. He'll be doing some basic reconfiguration work and cleaning out some of the fan screens. Aside from that, he'll be conducting a cargo conference with Chris Cassidy and Karen Nyberg with the teams here in Houston a little bit later this afternoon as they prepare for unloading all the cargo arriving on that HTV, over 3.6 tons of equipment coming up for these Expedition 36 astronauts. Then our final crew member, Karen Nyberg, earlier this morning was setting up the capillary flow experiment, which is a number of fluid physics experiments on board the station looking to investigate how various fluids move up surfaces via capillary action in microgravity. Results from this, hoping to improve models used down here on the ground to design low-gravity fluid systems and eventually improve fluid transfer systems for things like water and fuel on future spacecraft. Aside from that, Nyberg, again, spending her time setting up that HTV-4 control panel and completing some on-orbit robotics training for the Canada Arm 2.